Hey guys, Car Fanatic here. Today I'm going to be reviewing Rustoleum's Rock Guard spray. It's supposed to be a temporary clear bra type of Plasti Dip, and more importantly, it's advertised as being crystal clear when it dries. We'll go ahead and test this and see if it's actually true. The first step is just to clean off the headlight. I'm using detailer to spray and a microfiber cloth. Next, I'm going to use rubbing compound to polish my headlight so it's nice and shiny before I apply the rock guard to it. When I'm done, I'm just wiping off the excess polish. Now it's time to mask off the headlight. I'm beginning by applying a very light coat to the headlight. I'm going to repeat this. After applying 5 coats of rock guard, it's time to remove the masking. When removing the masking, I realized that I had a lot of running. The rock guard solution is actually much thinner than Plasti Dip, so this not only makes it hard to get a nice clean finish, it makes it more difficult to remove. In this instance, I applied 5 coats of Rustoleum's rock guard. It wasn't enough for me to remove it easily. I think I probably would have had to put 10 coats or so to be able to remove it in the same manner as you would Plasti Dip. After 3 attempts, I was able to get a decent finish on my headlights. I actually only applied it to the passenger side. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. You can see that it's not completely transparent. It's a little bit cloudy looking. Probably something I wouldn't keep on my car. Let's go ahead and compare it to the other headlight, which I didn't apply the rock guard to. It's much more transparent and a nice clean OEM finish.
So we applied the Rustoleum rock guard to the headlight, and we saw that, one, it wasn't crystal clear when it dried as advertised. The second thing we noticed is that the Rustoleum rock guard spray is actually really thin, so this leads to a lot of dripping. And additionally, it requires a ton of coats for you to get a layer that's thick enough for you to remove easily. Overall, it was pretty hard to remove, and I wouldn't recommend you apply this to your paint. Because it's so thin, any protection you get is going to be minimal, and you might actually end up doing more damage to your paint in the removal process. So overall, I think this might be okay to try for non-paint applications, but definitely be wary before applying this to your paint.
Thanks for watching, Car Fanatics. If you like this video and you'd like to see more, check out some of my other videos, and also hit that red subscribe button for new videos weekly.